only way out of Ashburton to the north tonight is by air, as floodwaters inundate roads around town and locals are urged to hunker down. The options to the south aren't much better, with 10 state highways in Canterbury closed. While the Ashburton River has receded a bit, people are being told to keep their bags packed because the call to evacuate could still come. Our reporter Louise Tanuth and cameraman Nathan McKinnon have this report.
A reprieve from the rain, but the risk isn't over in Ashburton.
Yeah, the river is still full and there's still pressure on there. We still haven't taken off the notice for the residents to for them having their bags packed, ready to go at short notice, so that is still in order there for them.
Mayor Neil Brown says the river's dropping slowly, but at 1,250 cubic metres, it's still far higher than its usual 10.
Not confident that it won't do it. It could still do it. We're still watching that very, very carefully because the flow is still very high. It could take a day or two for that to drop back to a level where we can remove that threat of flooding.
Farmers are among the worst affected and support is on offer.
We've got rural support trusters in our operations room next door and fielding phone calls from farmers who need assistance. We have one area of farmers which is worst hit, which is in the Green Street area, and they're being supported, and I've heard of helicopters flying some feed in for some that cannot drive to get feed into their stock.
Brian Beeston's one of the dairy farmers in that worst hit area. He says the flooding took hold faster than anticipated.
When we knew there was going to be a heavy rain, we didn't expect in the first 12 hours to get what we got, because we thought it'd be daylight, we see how much rain's coming, what's happening, we move the cattle. And the block we lost 60 hectares of had grazing for 300 yearlings. All of a sudden, you know, within 12 hours, gone, the whole block gone, and the heifer's gone. And at the moment, we've seen odd little groups around on the neighbouring properties.
He says the big focus is on finding missing animals.
But until the water goes down, you can't even get animals, because there's rivers where we're paddocks. And so until those rivers go down, you can't even get there with anything safely. So at the moment, is we're hoping these animals are all set around the neighbours.
Brian has one word to describe the last 2 days.
And it's just been chaos, and there's nothing we can do until it, like now, it stopped raining. Thank God it stopped raining, okay? So now we just have to let the water run its course, and that could be the next 12 hours or 24 hours.
Back in Ashburton Township, local residents that can still safely stay home are hunkering down. Rex Bennett's lived in Ashburton for 40 years. He says he's never seen rain like this before.
This would be the most rain I've ever seen here. Yes, it has been constant.
He's been checking the stock banks over the last 48 hours and feels safe for now. But they're still on standby and had to act quickly on Sunday.
I moved a couple of horses on Sunday afternoon. I wasn't concerned, but my younger family were, and I wanted to allay the affairs. But and we had bags packed with a bit of stuff and whatnot as in preparation.
A short drive away, Hakatere Marae's turned into an evacuation centre. Chair Michelle Brett says since they've opened, they've had more and more people turning up.
Well, when I arrived here last night, there was about 25, and then overnight there was probably about 16, 17 that stayed, and then today we had another group come through.